In this video, we're going to see the basics of working with samples in Cakewalk by BandLab. So, what actually is a sample? It's a small piece of audio that we can use to make our own music. They can either be created from synthesizers or they can be recorded like from real instruments. For now, that's all you need to know. The samples I use are all free ones that I downloaded from the internet. You can just Google free sample packs to get some of your own. By the term sample packs, it just means it's a pack or collection of audio samples with an overarching theme, usually a genre. Let's say you want to produce lo-fi music, then what you have to search is free lo-fi sample packs. If it's something else like future bass, then you search free future bass sample packs. Even though these samples are free, there is one thing that you have to make sure, and that is they are royalty free. Alright, let me show you where I keep all my audio samples. It's in D drive, sample packs. These are all sample packs that I downloaded from the internet, and they contain audio samples that we can use to make our own music. We can open the content of these folders from here itself, but let me show you how we can access these directly from inside Cakewalk. Keep this directory in mind. Let's close this file manager. In Cakewalk, we go to the inbuilt browser and click on this media tab. No matter where we are, we click on this up icon a few times to reach the desktop. Then we can go to the directory where we have our sample packs. It's in this PC, D drive, sample packs. This is the drop-down for saved preset locations. We can add any location to the list by clicking on this icon. Now we can quickly get to this folder by making use of this drop-down. In here, I am going into the Cymatics folder, where I keep all my sample packs that I got from Cymatics. Here, let's choose one sample pack. Drip. Okay, I'm going to open this Drip sample pack. In here, the first three folders are some typical content that we get in a typical sample pack. And we can see that there are mainly two types of samples, one-shots and loops. Let me show you what these one-shots are. So here, these drums one-shots contain 808s, claps, cymbals, kicks, and snares. So let's open kicks. It's actually a single kick, but we are hearing it in a loop. We can disable that by clicking here and disabling this loop preview. Cool. We can click and drag it in here. But I just noticed something that we have to do before starting a project in Cakewalk, and that is setting the right preferences. Here, we can see the sample rate and bit depth of the project that we are working in. 44.1 kHz of sample rate is a general standard for making music, especially songs, but the bit depth of 16-bit does not sit right with me. We can change it in preferences. We can either press P on the keyboard or just click on this number to bring up the relevant section in the preferences window. Here we can see the sampling rate is 4400, which is what we want. Then audio driver bit depth 24-bit. Well, then where is this 16-bit coming from? It's in this audio data section under file bit depths, record bit depth 16. I'm gonna change it to 24. Why is it necessary to set these things prior starting a project? Well, it's because of this option, always copy imported audio files. With this option, we can be sure that our project will not be messed up even if the original audio sample is lost. When we add an audio sample into a Cakewalk project, it's going to create a copy of that audio with a sample rate and bit depth specified in the preferences. The newly created file will be stored in this folder location if it's a project that is not yet saved, and if it is a saved project, the newly created audio will be kept inside the project folder. Now let me show you the default location where Cakewalk saves its projects. When we save a project, Cakewalk is going to create a folder with the same name as the project under this directory, and the Cakewalk file will be inside that folder along with another folder named audio, which keeps the audio files used inside the project. Let's bring it back to its initial directory. While we have the preferences open, here is one more setting that I recommend you to check. Under playback and recording, you can see this option, suspend audio engine when Cakewalk is not in focus. Keep this enabled. If this is not enabled, sometimes Cakewalk can take full control of your audio driver and the other applications that you have open might not be able to output any sound. Now I'm gonna press apply. Close. It has not changed yet, so we are going to close this project and create another one. Let's see if it changes. Empty project. Yep, it does. Let's continue from where we left off. Media, sample packs, cymatics, drip sample pack, drums one shots, kicks. Okay, it's back in loop. Alright. I think I like this kick. Now I'm going to click this and drag it and drop it here. An audio track has been created and the sample is arranged at the beginning of the timeline. Now let's pick up a snare. Okay, I'm going to take this one, click it and drag it and drop it here on this line. Audio track is created and the audio clip is in the audio track where we dropped it. Now let's add the other kind of sample, which is not one shots, and that is loops. Let's first take a look at drum loops. There are different kind of loops, full drum loops, or the loops of the top drums, or hi-hat loops. Next, let's bring in the other kind of loop, that is melody loops. Here we can see guitar loops. I'm going to take in a melody loop. Alright. Now, for some time, we will not be needing this browser window. We can click here to collapse this or alternatively press B on the keyboard, which is a shortcut for browser. And also we can get rid of this inspector by clicking here to collapse it or pressing I on the keyboard. So now we have more space to work. The first thing I want here is the grid lines that we can find from this view, display, vertical grid lines. Behind clips is what I usually use, so there we have it. By the way, all the windows that appear in Cakewalk does have these kind of menus related to that respective window. Just keep that in mind. Any clip on this timeline will snap to these lines if the snap settings is turned on. If it is turned off, we can move it much more freely. The shortcut for toggling snap is N. Let's zoom in further, hold down Alt key and scroll. Right now, the snap setting is set to Smart Grid, that's why it adjusted according to our zooming. Let's turn that off and choose another resolution. Turning off snap. Turning on. Alright. Now we are going to arrange this to make some musical sense. Right click and drag this out. Let's work with these two samples now. Select this snare sample. Place the mouse on top where it changes into this symbol and click and drag it while holding Ctrl key. Alright, now this dotted line that we are seeing is called aim assist. It is useful sometimes but right now it's annoying me, so I'm going to disable that by pressing X. Now we are going to click on the kick sample and hold on Ctrl again. So we have this thing going on. Now we are going to bring in this hi-hat loop. We had to place the mouse on top here again and click and drag. Well, something seems wrong, right? That's because the tempo of our project is 120 and this loop is in 140. So we have to stretch this to fit the time. Usually these kind of loops extend 4 bars. So 1, 2, 3, 4. It should finish at this 5th line. Normally, if we click and drag on the corner of an audio clip, it will go like this. But if we hold down Ctrl and Shift keys and then do the same, it will stretch. There we have it. It's in time. Let's extend these samples still here. When the cursor is showing this symbol, click and drag like this, selecting this section and press Ctrl and D. It duplicates it. If this mouse is not showing the right symbol, it's because you probably have the wrong tool selected. You can select the tools from this section, or alternatively, you can click on the scroll button of the mouse to show it. It's the same thing that you can see here. Now this loop is already in 120 BPM as you can see, so we can just drag it and place it there. And now we have this. Alright, let's say we want this same thing to be played 4 times, except for this part. Let me make some space to work now. Now I'm going to select this section like this and press Ctrl plus D. Okay, it's duplicated. Just like I said, we don't want this thing to happen. So what I'm going to do is split it here. To do that, we hold down Alt and left click. So it's split now. Having the snap turned on will make sure that it is split on one of these lines. Now we can delete this and then duplicate this one. Now, in order to select the whole thing, we have to zoom out. Now we select this again and Ctrl plus D. So we essentially made a 7-second loop into 32 seconds. We can add fade into these audio clips. To do that, we hover over this corner like this. When we see that triangle thing, just click and drag. That is going to give us a fade. We can dictate how the curve of this fade should be by placing the mouse on this top corner and right-clicking when that triangle thing comes up. Now, we can choose the type of curve that we want. These are some basic stuff that we can do with audio samples in Cakewalk. There is a lot more that we can do to these. For starters, if we click on an audio sample and then go to process, we can see a lot of effects that we can apply on these audio samples. Let me show this transpose just as an example. Let's transpose it one semitone up. Okay, now listen to the difference between these samples. I'm going to undo this now. And that's it for this video. In the next video, we will discuss about samplers. This is ADK, and I'll catch you later.